Easter.
COVID-19.
Vaccine work.
I want to teach you. I'm going to get the COVID-19 vaccine soon.
Yay!
I'm a little nervous and excited. Learning about things helps you feel braver.
Let's be brave!
So let me tell you what I learned. Most people get COVID.
Achoo! Sneeze, sneeze.
From breathing the virus. Viruses have two main parts of them. They have instructions to help them build more viruses. Kind of like Lego instructions. They also have a capsid. It's a container that holds the instructions. That capsid also has spikes that help it sneak inside cells. The virus uses the spike protein kind of like a key. So why do viruses want to go in cells? Well, viruses can't make copies by themselves. So they use the stuff inside cells to make more of them. Once all of the pieces are made, the pieces come together to make a complete virus. These new viruses leave the cell, infecting new cells, and making even more viruses and spread throughout the body. Oh no! So how does our body try to stop a virus infection? First we have our innate immune response.
Innate immune response.
These are cells in our body that try to fight off things that they don't recognize, like neutrophils. They eat the virus, send out a signal.
A what?
But then they die. There are also mast cells that send out signals for help.
Help!
And we can't forget the macrophage.
The macrophage
can eat a lot of virus. Innate immune cells are really good at helping our body as soon as they notice an infection. But they are not always strong enough to stop an infection from spreading. That's why we have the adaptive immune response.
Adaptive immune response.
It has two main types of cells. First are the T cells.
Hey.
The macrophage shows a T cell a piece of the virus. And the T cell goes and start dividing into special types of T cells that help regulate our immune response.
Next are the B cells.
Hi-yo.
They will eat the virus and then wait for a T cell to come and tell them what it is.
What's this?
When the T cell says, that's the virus. B cell goes,
whoa,
and starts dividing into cells that create antibodies. Antibodies are super cool. They do lots of things to help our body. First, they signal for more immune cells. They also stick to the virus's
spike proteins. Sticky splat.
Covered or opsonized viruses stick together in clumps.
Sticky.
Clumped up viruses are much easier for macrophages to eat. Finally, since antibodies cover up the spike protein, it stops the virus from getting inside cells. T and B cells also make special memory cells, so our body can remember how to stop the virus if we get infected again.
T cells, B cells, and antibodies are really good at stopping infections from spreading.
Phew. But here's the problem.
when our body first gets infected.
Achoo! Sneeze, sneeze.
It doesn't have T's or B's ready. It takes 2 or 3 weeks for our body to make B and T cells for that virus. That gives the virus a huge head start. So by the time our T cells and B cells are ready,
our body could have a huge infection.
This is why we get vaccines. Vaccines have been around for hundreds of years, and there's a lot of types of them. The vaccine that I'm gonna get is called an mRNA vaccine. They were developed from research by Dr. Catalin Carrico. To make these vaccines,
scientists take the genetic instructions from the coronavirus and find the part that tells how to make the spike protein. We want these instructions because we want our body to make antibodies that can stick to the spike protein.
They cut up or splice the instructions. Then they get rid of all the other virus stuff.
Wrap the instructions up. I'll explain why in just a second. Then they take the wrapped spike protein instruction and put them in the vaccine. So when we go to the doctor and receive the vaccine, our body is receiving the instructions for the spike protein without being infected by the coronavirus. Now let me explain why we wrap up the spike protein instructions.
These instructions are made out of RNA.
RNA has a charge, and so does the cell membrane. That's the outside of the cell. Because they have the same charge,
they repel each other like magnets. So, scientists cover the spike protein RNA, which helps it slip inside the cell. This allows the cell to make copies of the spike protein
without making copies of the virus, which means our body can build B and T cells that can recognize the coronavirus spike protein, make antibodies, and create memory cells that will protect us from future infections.
So when you go to the doctor and get your COVID-19 vaccine, you are getting medicine that teaches your body to make T and B cells and antibodies that will protect you from day one.
This helps you to not get as sick if you get infected.
Cough, cough.
And by minimizing a viral infection, you won't be as likely to spread it to others. That's a really important thing. We want to keep each other safe. I hope this video helps you feel braver and more excited to get the COVID-19 vaccine. If you have more questions, here are some videos that teach how the coronavirus spreads and how vaccines are made. And here's a special video I made all by myself about COVID-19 and how to protect yourself. Thanks for watching. Bye!
And then maybe at the end I will say,
superhero vaccine!